Shout out YouTube. Shout out world. Peace and love to everybody that rocks with me, man. You know what I'm saying? I go by the name of No Face the Rambler. And I'm back at it, man. Back to popping my shit. Back to kicking the realness. You know what I'm saying? And bringing that raw and uncut truth to my channel, man. To all my subscribers, man. You know, my loved ones. People that rock with me, man. You got to check out my brothers, man. My brothers, we from the same block, from the same hood, from the same soil. You know what I'm saying? They got a YouTube channel out, and it's called Know the Code. You know what I'm saying? Definitely check it out, man. Definitely check it out. You know what I'm saying? I guarantee you, that funk, that raw energy, just great conversation from great minds dealing with great people, you will definitely find on that page right there, on that channel. You know what I'm saying? Know the Code, man. Remember that. You know what I'm saying? Hey, yo, man, I'm about to verbally step into a territory, man, that's the shaky ground for a lot of individuals, man, but I think it's time that we chop it up, you know what I'm saying? I think it's time that we take it there, man, because to be real with you, man, I'm sick of this shit, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to my homie Shabazz, man, the great enlightened conscious minds. Every time we build, man, I swear to God, son, it's like playing this move and the earth shakes, you know what I'm saying? Because that means God's in the mist, word is bond, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, me and the homie Baz, man, we build a lot. And these are topics that we talk about, man. And I'm going to step off into this territory because this is something that needs to be spoken about, needs to be heard, you know what I'm saying? And this is to the sisters, man. Pardon the body, but it's to the sisters, man. You know what I'm saying? Not all, but there's a large portion out there, man. A large portion out there who won't accept accountability. They run from accountability. And they fail to acknowledge accountability for their actions, behaviors, mannerisms, attitude, communication skills, and just whatever they're into. You know what I'm saying? And I mean, you know, to be fair and balanced, man, it's a lot of dudes out there, man. You know, it's a large portion of black dudes, man, who really ain't shit, you know what I'm saying? Who really aren't trying to build or move us forward as a race of people, man. But this one right here, man, this one right here is for the women, you know what I'm saying? Because this is something that they got to hear, you know what I mean? And I'm going to speak on it, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to speak on it, man. No holding back. You know, first off, pardon the body, man. Shit. But first off, man, you know, we're going to get into it with this accountability, man, with this myth that a lot of these females conjure up, and particularly in the black community, that black men ain't shit, you know what I mean? That black men just abandon their children. That, you know, black men just have sex with a female, get her pregnant, and then they out, you know what I'm saying? Let's abandon that myth, man. Come on, ladies, keep it real, keep it a buck, you know what I'm saying? Keep it a buck, man. You know what I'm saying? You was involved with this individual. You liked this individual. You was attracted to this individual because he was out there doing things outside of the law of where we reside in America to create some type of financial base for itself. Excuse me again. A wealth for itself and resources for itself. And you was attracted to that, you know what I'm saying? You got involved with this individual. Things occurred as far as when y'all got intimate. And you began to conceive during 9 months. You told this individual that you were pregnant. And for the first 4 to 5 months during your pregnancy, this individual is still out there on the block getting it, as he knows best. But somewhere around the 7th or 8th month, this individual realized that shit's getting real because the kid's on the way. So this individual is a representation of a lot of black males from the east to the west, to the dirty south to the Midwest, you know what I'm saying? He decided it's time to put the work down, man, and educate himself in this system, and also get a job in this system, under the side of the law, you know what I'm saying? So he can legally be there for you and the child that you have, which you're holding in your belly, you know what I'm saying? And when he decided to do that, put the work down, and go to school at night, and get a 9 to 5, you woman, who couldn't and won't accept accountability, you didn't like the fact that the $2,000 a night that you was getting from this guy was over. That $2,000 a night that you was getting from this guy basically turned to 150, because he got a 9 to 5 and was basically pulling in between 475 to 500 a week. And you couldn't accept that. Also the fact that he was going to school trying to better himself, but you wanted that fast cash that he was getting. So when the baby drops, the baby's born, you start to cause this rift with him, and you push him out your life. Just keep it a buck, you know what I mean? You push him out your life. You push him out your life. And you go out there and you seek others that was getting it the way he was before he decided to have a change of direction in his life. You know what I'm saying? Let's keep it a buck, ladies, for real. Let's keep it real, man. Let's keep it real. You know what I'm saying? You pushed that individual out your life, man. And you chased another individual that was getting it like he was before he changed direction. And the cycle is ongoing. And by the time you're in your mid-30s, you got 7 bastard babies by 5 different men. And you got 2 out of the 5 who you keep around, that you bang for child support, and whenever you need shit, you got them coming in and aiding and assisting you with that. And the other 3 out of the 5, one is dead, 2 is locked up. You see what I'm saying? So you constantly keep a revolving door. But these are things that you don't want to admit. These are things that you don't want to accept. These are things that you hide from. And this code of honor that you have with these sisters that think like you, it will never be broken, because you don't want to admit this shit. You don't want to admit this shit. You know what I'm saying? And I'm from the hood, yo. Like, I've known plenty of dudes that had intercourse with women, and they was purely attracted on some sexual shit. And as soon as that female ended up getting pregnant, I never heard any dudes sit up and say, like, man, fuck that, man. That ain't my kid. I don't want that baby, man. Fuck that bitch. Never heard no dude say that. I might have heard an individual say, that ain't my baby, but I'm going to go attempt to get a blood test, and if that is, then I'm going to handle my responsibility. But I never heard any dude around my way say, man, you know, fuck that. I don't want no kid, you know what I'm saying? Fuck that kid, and blah, blah, blah. Never heard that. I never heard that. So let's dispel that. And I'm not saying that there ain't dudes out there like that, but I'm just saying the majority, let's keep it a buck. You women push them out of your life for your reasons. And 9 times out of 10, it all falls back to the fact that he wasn't getting that fast money. You know what I'm saying? He wasn't doing the things he was doing while you were pregnant. and you couldn't accept that. Let's keep it a buck, you know what I'm saying? Then for the majority of you sisters, I'm not going to say you're a direct opposition of black unity, but the majority of you sisters have no reason to unify, because it'll fuck what you got up as far as your plans and your lifestyle with these bastard children you got. You know what I'm saying? If you got 5 kids, 3 different baby fathers, 2 of the 3 are locked up, and one kind of just comes around when you need him and you're begging him for child support or whatever, then you have your resources out there on a block by them single mothered, weird ass niggas out there that's hustling and doing whatever the fuck they doing. They have no direction in life beside the criminal side. You know what I'm saying? So you need them. You round one nigga to lay the pipe to you to give you the weed. You round one nigga to lay the pipe to you to give you some drink. You round another nigga to lay the pipe to you so he can take you to the club or floss. And you allow another nigga to lay the pipe to you for trick money so you can live your life. You know what I'm saying? So let's be real, man. I mean, you sisters that are into that, you really have no desire for black unity or for a family structure, because it doesn't fit your lifestyle, it doesn't fit your wants, it doesn't fit what you feel to be suitable for the way you live your life. You know what I'm saying? And we gotta be honest about that. But a lot of you sisters don't wanna accept accountability. You don't at all. At all. And I'm an 80s baby, you know what I'm saying? I'm an 80s baby, man. So I remember growing up, seeing little snippets of Oprah, Jenny Jones, all these other talk shows, news outlets, and even on the radio. You know what I'm saying? Before all this Wi-Fi and for the internet was popping and all that shit. You know what I'm saying? But I remember, man, from the 80s, actually, you know, from the late 60s and up, but from the 80s when I was born, I remember it was a national and international platform for you sisters to manipulate, distort, and tell these fictitious tales of black males in your community. And along with these white feminists, you allow them to paint this horrific picture of black males within the community. And you had this on a national and international platform, in which a lot of you sisters came up off of. Got filthy rich, you know what I'm saying? Let's be honest. Now there's a balance there that could nobody see. And the balance I'm talking about is the internet. Because you got a lot of brothers now coming out the woodworks. Nah, this is my side. Now you see it. You know what I'm saying? Now you see it. Now you see it. This is what's really going on. The truth is always going to rise, because the truth is the light, and the truth is always going to shine in the darkness. You know what I'm saying? But it's real. It's definitely real. You know what I'm saying? And these are things that a lot of you sisters don't want to speak about. You got Negro bad bucks out here. You know what I'm saying? You got these black dudes out here, man, you know, in these interracial relationships, man. But let's keep it a buck. You know what I'm saying? For the majority of them, there's not a large portion of black men in these interracial relationships, these Negro bad bucks, that are taking a national and international platform to bash black women. On the other hand, you Negro bedwinches, you black women that are in these interracial relationships, are taking a national and an international platform to bash black men. To bash black men. And come up with this fictitious bullshit of why you're doing what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? It's like, where the fuck that come from? Where the fuck is this at? Where are we headed? You know what I'm saying? Why so much destruction? Why so much chaos? Why so much confusion? Because you don't want to accept accountability. Like I said, I'm an 80s baby, man. And aside from the government's infiltration of crack cocaine and the CIA Quantel program and all that, you sisters, not all, but a large contribution of you black women are the reason that the black community, aka the ghetto, is what it is today. And that's something that you don't want to admit to. That's something that you have problems accepting. That's something that you know, but you would never admit to knowing it. Because you would never ever break that code. But we know. And I know. And again, you know, I'm not here bashing you. I'm just saying, man, keep a buck. Accept accountability. You know what I'm saying? I accept plenty of accountabilities in my life. I was locked up for 10 years, man. Out of my children's lives. Something that I did. Nobody forced me to go out there and hustle. Nobody forced me to go out there and rob anybody. I did that off my own merit. And me and my oldest son, we speak a lot. He vents out to me and everything, and I accept it. Because I know what I've done. And outside of the gender shit, being an adult, that's what it is. It's acknowledging and accepting accountability and responsibility. You know what I'm saying? Yo, this is no face to rambler, man. I'm just putting that in your cup, man. Why don't you sip on that and think about that, ladies? And again, I'm not bashing you. I'm just keeping it a buck. It's pro love and no love, man. 2018 to beyond. Peace.